Mommy's taking us to the zoo tomorrow. Zoo tomorrow, zoo tomorrow. Mommy's taking us to the zoo tomorrow. We can stay all day. Going to the zoo, zoo, zoo. How about you, you, you? You can come too, too, too. We're going to the zoo, zoo, zoo. Look at all the monkeys swinging in the trees, swinging in the trees, swinging in the trees. Look at all the monkeys swinging in the trees. We can stay all day. Going to the zoo, zoo, zoo. How about you, you, you? You can come too, too, too. We're going to the zoo, zoo, zoo. Look at all the crocodiles swimming in the water, swimming in the water, swimming in the water. Look at all the crocodiles swimming in the water. We can stay all day. We're going to the zoo, zoo, zoo. How about you, you, you? You can come too, too, too. We're going to the zoo, zoo, zoo. Yes, mommy's taking us to the zoo tomorrow. Zoo tomorrow, zoo tomorrow. Mommy's taking us to the zoo tomorrow. We can stay all day. We're going to the zoo, zoo, zoo. How about you, you, you? You can come too, too, too. We're going to the zoo, zoo, zoo. Going to the zoo, zoo, zoo. How about you, you, you? You can come too, too, too. We're going to the zoo, zoo, zoo.
My name is Ken Claiborne. I'm a member of the Board of Trustees of this congregation. Welcome to all of you. The Unitarian Universalist Fellowship of Elkhart is a welcoming community encouraging religious freedom, nurturing individual spiritual and ethical growth, celebrating diversity, and promoting a just and sustainable world. If you'd like to learn more about this fellowship, please look at our website at uufe.org and join us after the service for our coffee hour. For the listening enjoyment of all, we ask that you at this time please turn off your cell phones or turn them to the vibrate mode. Also, if you need hearing support, please see the gentleman at the sound desk and they'll provide you an assistant. I have some announcements this morning. We're planning to restart the Science and Society program beginning this coming Tuesday, August 13th at 2 p.m. in the Gathering Place. We'll view the first episode of the six-part PBS program, A Brief History of the Future, presented by futurist Ari Wallach. Here's a synopsis of the first program. It's called Beyond the Now. The series widens our perspective of time beyond our lifetimes and joins Ari Wallach as he embarks on a journey to seek the individuals and ideas that will shape the future and help provide a more sustainable future for each generation. Today, Pam Wycliffe is inviting all of those interested in writing letters encouraging voters to please join her in the Gathering Place during the coffee hour to discuss details. She has various envelopes, that kind of thing. Hopefully we can set some plans to make our contribution by using mailings and letter writing to encourage folks to vote in the upcoming election. This is a project that the Social Justice Committee has agreed to support. And we know that there are members in the fellowship who have expressed interest in supporting this action. We have an announcement from Carolee Searles, who couldn't be here today. She says, good morning. Would I add this to the announcements, which I'm doing? I'm unable to be there today, but I would like to encourage everyone to please notice the new exhibit in our art gallery. The paintings are original works by various artists. Caroline Anderson collected them over many years and hopes that you will enjoy them. She wishes to express the thanks to herself, and Emily Morrison and Carolyn for generously giving their time and knowledge to hanging these works. The portable defibrillator is here, and we're trying to schedule times to train folks how to use it. We need a minimum of 6 people. There are 4 that are signed up on the clipboard at the Ivy Island. So if you're interested and you'd like to sign up, if we get 2 more people, we can schedule to have the trainer from Elkhart General Hospital come here and show us how to use it. Let's see. I think that's pretty much it. Ta-da. Thank you all.
My assistants, Bristol, Garber, and Brooklyn. Garber. We're going to do the gong first. We ring the gong 3 times. Once for those who came before us and built a place for us. Once for those who are here now. And once for those who will come after us and build on the dream. Thank you, Bristol. And this is our chalice lighting for this morning. A light of life be kindled again in our hearts as we meet together this morning to celebrate the joy of human community, seeking a wholeness that extends beyond ourselves. Thank you, Brooklyn. And now we're going to, oops, you okay? Thanks, girls. You can sit back down. And Juniper Weston is gonna, let's see, how are we gonna do this? Let's use this other microphone. I think it's on. Can you start us in the unison covenant? Should we say it together? Love is the spirit of this church, and sweetness is its law, to dwell together in peace, to seek the truth in love, and to help one another. This is our covenant. Thank you, Juniper.
Okay, so I'm going to be reading a story today about new beginnings because many of our students are going to be going back to school and some of the rest of us are going to be starting new things as well. So the book that I'm reading today is also, it's kind of a cute little coincidence, but it's written by Holly Mead and it's called If I Never Forever Endeavor. If in all of forever I never endeavor to fly, I won't know if I can. I won't know if I can't. I won't know if or whether a flight I might fly should I choose to not ever give it a try. On the one wing, I could try and find that I flap and I flail, flounder and plummet, look foolish and fail. On the other wing, I could try and take flight, rise high and float free, sail through the trees. If I did endeavor and found my wings clever, I could see the world. or get lost in it. My nest is so nice, the nicest of nests. Who needs to fly, ever? I think I'll forget all about this endeavor. But look there, if I don't fly, I won't know what it is to swoop low or soar high, or what it's like to pluck a sweet bug from the sky. I won't know how it feels to scallop the air with a dip and a glide. Or float alongside a friend, sigh. I suppose I could try a little flap, a flutter, or two. Flutter, thwack, thud, thump. Flap, flutter, flap, flap. Fly. Look at me. I'm dipping and gliding and daring and flying. If I hadn't endeavored and found my wings clever, I never a sky would have scaled. Never a world would have seen, and never a friend would have found. Friends of a feather, I say, endeavor and fly. Thank you.
If you're willing and able, let's stand and sing number 203, All Creatures of the Earth and Sky. Stand, please. Thank you.
And now it's time for our offering, and this morning's offering will be shared with the Woodlawn Nature Center.
My name is Misty, and I'm part of the RE committee, and I'm going to introduce our kids. So as I say their name, I'm just going to have them stand up, and when I'm done, Oliver is going to help us do a slideshow. So I have Trey, I have Lucas, I have Maddox, I have Bristol, I have Brooklyn, and I have Juniper and Oliver. Oh, sorry, Xander. I skipped right over you. And these are our kids in RE. There are a few missing, but this is what we strive every week to help. Yeah, they do a great job. They really do deserve it.
Slideshow that we did.
There you go. That's good.
Reflecting, we learned about the seven principles of the Unitarian Universalism. We performed music together. We created crafts together. We learned about different traditions. We completed a service project for the Potawatomi Zoo. We voted to decide which items to buy. And these are all the items that we decided to get. We had a bake sale and used a donation box to collect money for the zoo. We took the things we brought to the zoo. The zookeeper showed us some special things, like we saw the red panda use the wobble stool we purchased for them. As you can see, she put the wobble table down, and then she put some food on there. And then the red panda just got up there. And then she explained some things about the red panda. We enjoyed our trip to the zoo, so we did the carousel. We also got to do the petting zoo.
And we fed the goats.
We fed the goats some more, even though they don't need any more. We also fed the giraffe, which is a new thing at the zoo. And that's it.
Trey, I think, has a short reading for us, and I'm going to just hold the mic, or his mom's going to hold the mic.
All things are connected. Like the blood which unites one family. All things are connected. Whatever befalls the earth, befalls the sons of the earth. Man did not weave the web of life. He is merely a strand in it. Whatever he does to the web, he does to himself. Chief Seattle, 1854.
Well, I'm the old guy feeling like a kid all the time, so put up with me for a little bit, and then I got a surprise for you. The Owls of Elkhart County recently had a guest speaker come to Elkhart and talk to us about the Constitution of the United States. Jeffrey Rosen is the director of the National Constitution Center, and his most recent book, The Pursuit of Happiness, was the topic of discussion. One of Jeffrey's goals in his position at the NCC is to get people involved in dialogue about the Constitution. That's why the Owls group intrigued Jeffrey enough to come and speak to us and the community. There were over 300 people in attendance at that meeting, and several of you were there. In follow-up conversations with Jeffrey since then, he has shared with us one of the strongest concerns about his strongest concerns about the conditions of the United States right now is the low interest level in reading by young people. We all know the culprit, as well as lower requirements in education for a reading aptitude. But this same culprit can give you access to just about all the books in the world. At this point in my life, history and current events are my main interest. Actually, I'm quite anal about it. With so many books coming to the market weekly, it's hard to keep up or curb my addiction to buy more and more. 99% of my 970 books are nonfiction. I have them categorized into 22 different subject matters, with the topic, the five top categories being inspiration, meditation, religion, politics, and ethnic minority, LGBTQ, indigenous people, and then Bible study and reference. The goal now is to concentrate on reading these books. I'm trying to read at least one a week for whatever time I got left to read books. What is an old guy like me sharing all this with these kids on a day meant to celebrate them and their futures with learning and school and lots of potential? Because I missed out on the joy of books until I was very old. And today's libraries and online opportunities give today's kids an endless selection of books of their choosing. The world really does exist between the pages of billions of words and books printed down through the ages. All you have to do is start reading to make that discovery. Yes, it's going to be a different future for these kids and their remembered past, for the Gen Alpha Polars born between 2013 and 2029 from my childhood experience. And it is my hope that the kids today do not have my experience and lose out on the great opportunities before them to read starting at a very young age. Having said that, let's get to the good stuff. I liked art class, I hope all of you guys do, but I couldn't draw very well. And the only animals I could draw was a bird, because at least it looked like a bird. So anyway, putting your trip to the zoo together and wanting to buy a book that would represent all of that, I found some cool books. This is a series of Draw 50 series. They got all kinds of series of different subject matters. And this is Draw 50 Animals. So as I call your name, you come up and you grab a book, and it's yours. And hopefully you'll find your favorite animal in here, and especially the ones you saw at the zoo. So Brooklyn and Bristol, would you come up? And Oliver, you can come with her too. Trey? Xander? And Lucas and Maddox, and I got one for River also. You can give that to your brother now, okay? I'll put this other one in the library for anybody that wants it later, okay? Thank you.
For our blessing of the backpacks, my name is Renee Rocco, and I'm the chair for the Religious Education Committee. We're going to do the blessing of the backpacks. I invite all the RE committee members to come up to the front of the sanctuary at this time. You can bring up a bag or something that you'll use while teaching our kids here this year. Today we have Shari and Holly and Misty, and we're missing Taylor today. Now I'd like our young people who will be participating in school this year to come up to the front. Also, any parents, teachers, caregivers, or any adults who will participate in education for themselves. You can bring a backpack or any item you'll be using each day. Thank you. UUFE has a spirit of love here in our church. We can bring along the love of our congregation when we're faced with challenges during school or work. The love of our congregation can follow you to help you know peace wherever you are. Let's all make sure these children and adults can carry the love of our congregation with them to help them to have a successful school year. Let's all gather our most precious and powerful love and push it into this holy water. Sometimes we feel nervous or worried when we go to school or work, and we wish we felt braver. It would be nice to know our congregation's courage is with us during those times too. Let's all summon our strongest feelings of bravery and push them forward into the holy water. Now we have this water that is full of the love and courage of the members of our church. We are going to give each of you a few precious drops of the water to bless your backpack or other item or yourself, so that you can carry these feelings with you every day of the school year. But can you do it? I don't know if you want. And I think we had a song.
Fall is here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell, brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence, books and pens, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Walk with me, Susie Lee, through the park and by the tree, we can rest upon the ground and look at all the bugs we found. Safely walk to school without a sound. We safely walk to school without a sound. Well, here we are, no one else. We walk to school all by ourselves. There's dirt on our uniforms from chasing all the ants and worms. We clean up and now it's time to learn. We clean up and now it's time to learn. Numbers, letters, learn to spell, nouns and books and show and tell. Playtime, we will throw the ball, then back to class, through the hall. Teacher marks our height against the wall. The teacher marks our height against the wall. We don't notice any time pass, 'cause we don't notice anything. We sit side by side in every class. The teacher thinks that I sound funny, but she likes it when you sing. Tonight I'll dream in my bed while silly thoughts run through my head of the bugs and alphabet. And when I wake tomorrow, I'll bet you and I will walk together again. 'Cause I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
Remember that the spirit of life is with you at school and at work. The congregation's love is with you no matter where you are. And whenever you need more love or courage, you can ask for it. After, oh, and that's it. Thank you.
Well, obviously we have plenty of time for congregational reflections, so I'm going to start out with TJ.
Well, I'm also concerned about writing skills. It appears that, you know, we use so many acronyms when we're sending out emails electronically that I think that we've lost the art of writing. And in addition to spelling.
Okay.
I want to congratulate our worship associate and everyone involved in this service. It was wonderful. You all deserve even more rounds of applause. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
I would just like to take a moment to say that I'm thankful for electronics and tablets and phones and stuff, because when you have children who have poor dexterity, poor fine motor skills, have dyslexia and stuff, sometimes it's hard for them to read and write. And so those tools really come in handy and are very helpful.
I want to add on what Courtney said. I have really bad handwriting, so like I basically type all the time. Gets me used.
I want to second what Joan said, and I think that our RE committee has done is doing an amazing job with the kids. And something that I remember from Sophia Foz, who is a UU beginner kind of our RE stuff. And she always said, and I don't know all the children. I'm not good at that, but she said, all these children are all our children. And so we are all, as a congregation, responsible for all these children. And so we all need to do better. I need to do better about learning who they are and what they're all about. But thank you very much for doing what you're doing every year.
Yeah, I have two things. One is, I remember BC times before COVID. We didn't have any young people. And so it's really nice to see the young people coming. And the other thing, the dilemma about reading, and I was in the classroom a long time. So, some kids don't like reading because of school. And I loved reading because my family read. But school could have killed it for me because I hated that round robin reading stuff. It created so much anxiety. And the problem is, too, in school, we tend to start panicking about age 6 or 7 if they're not reading. We start panicking. And then we double down. And if a kid is a reluctant reader and they don't like the school version, and then we double down, we could be just putting up a bigger wall between them and what Steve was talking about. So it's tricky. And the writing is tricky too. But I think it can be done. It's just we have to be careful not to do more harm than good by, first of all, by panicking and then making reading such a chore and such a, such an unpleasant experience, the kids don't understand the joy of it.
I'd like to follow up on what Pam said too, and that is that the RE committee has, I think, also really done a good job this year, but that's because of the leadership of Renee Ruocco. She has pushed us sometimes and just been there to lead us and been there for us and done all kinds of creative things, like she bought us these t-shirts, and she's always thinking about ways to give back to the teachers and the children. So she deserves a round of applause.
Hi, my name is Susan Hom, and I'm visiting you all today from Encinitas, California, where I'm the chair of our RE committee, and I'm feeling very inspired. We have a little bit larger congregation, but very often the children come up front and then disappear, and so the joy of actually being introduced to the children is just such a wonderful idea, and I think I'm going to take this service back to our fellowship. It's very inspiring. Thank you.
I also want to thank the other members of our committee. They've been amazing, and I can't do it myself and they can't do it themselves, so we really are a team, and it takes all of us to make sure that we're caring for our kids in the best way possible. So thank you to them as well. As a teacher, I would say I agree with what Carl said as well, and there's always hope for our kids and their bright futures, and supporting teachers and understanding education and all of the things that come along with it are so important, so that you can help when you see a concern with how our kids are learning and growing. And testing doesn't help with the joy of learning. So I would love to see that, some of the state testing go by the wayside. But I always have hope that we're raising a bright future for these kids.
I'm just proud for everyone just learning something new, because you never know where you're going to find out.
I loved Holly's book. Yeah. And a friend of mine returned this to me today. And it's something by Aeneas Nin. And it says, "And then the day came when the risk to remain tight in a bud was more painful than the risk it took to blossom." And it so fits.
I'm Janelle, and I'm one of the hardworking people on our worship committee. And y'all did such a great job today. I wanted to know if any of you kids who would like to sometime maybe be a part of a regular service, a service where you're not all the stars, would any of you like to be a part of a service sometime? Do something with us? Trey? Xander?
Let him think about it.
Well, he already has, so that's why I was sort of calling him out. Yeah. Think about it. Let us know. Shari is on our committee as well, so you've got a direct line to her. There are lots of different things that you could do. We're not going to force you to do something you don't want to do, believe me. And thanks for today. We all know how much potential we have.
Okay, I think we might be ready for our last hymn.
Thank you, kids. This was a great service. Stand if you're willing and able, and let's sing 301, the first three verses. Stand if you're willing and able. Thank you. Touch the earth, reach the sky.
I think this one had all five, Steve.
Okay. Whatever. No, this is a short one, isn't it? It's okay. Touch the earth. Thank you.
Thanks for leading us, Steve. Our benediction today is by J. Abernathy, Jr. We affirm that love is our greatest purpose. Accepting one another is the truest form of faithful living. The search for truth is our constant star. We pledge our hearts, minds, and hands to challenge injustice with courage, to find hope in times of fear, and to live out our Unitarian Universalist values every day as a beloved community. Thus do we covenant with each other and with all that is sacred in life. Go in peace. But first, let's listen to our final song.
The first time I knew that you existed, my heart jumped up and it insisted, open up wide, let you inside. Ever since then we've been connected, I love you much more than I expected. Can we be friends? I hope it never ends. I love you. Smiling at me, I came to the zoo just to be with you. Wish I could climb your tree and sit by your side. When people look at us, their eyes get wide. Can they see what you mean?